not a qualified physician, and I don't want to give this injection. I am not a qualified physician, and I don't want to give this injection. Dorothy is begging for trouble, she is insisting I give her this needle. But darling, one thing you ought to know, don't blame me for where the needle go. I push it in, she pulls it out. I push it back, she starts to shout, Dr. Kitt, you're terrible, I can't stand the sight of your needle. She lay down in such a position, it was difficult to give this injection. She started holding onto the needle, making me so uncomfortable. I said, darling, can't you be steady? I'm going to have it in very shortly. She said, Dr. Kitt, I am sorry, but the sight of the needle frightened me. I push it in, she pulls it out, I push it back, she starts to shout, Dr. Kitt, you're terrible, I can't stand the sight of your needle. She still wouldn't lie down quietly, constantly moving her body. So I slap her in the face with vexation, and I go and give me the injection. She screamed out, stop it, I can't stand the pain, I don't think you're inside the right vein. I said, you stupid girl, you wouldn't be told, the needle must be sticking in the wrong hole. I push it in, she pulls it out, I push it back, she starts to shout, Dr. Kitt, you're terrible, I can't stand the sight of your needle. I pull it from the hole and start again. I have the needle now in the right vein. The needle just gone in half an inch. The stupid young lady starts to flinch. Suddenly she bawled, dread, it's working! I can feel the penicillin going in. I said, you silly fool, look what you do!